FTP is a term that you hear a little bit on GCN, and it stands for your functional threshold power. In this video, we're going to tell you how you can find your FTP, or if you don't have a power meter, the equivalent with a heart rate, which is your functional threshold heart rate. Now, first of all though, a bit more detail. What actually is your FTP? Well, it's a term first coined by Dr. Andrew Coggan, and it refers to the maximum average power that you can sustain for an hour. So for an experienced cyclist, that might be like a 40 kilometer time trial. And it's really, really useful because it gives a great indication of your cycling performance. It refers to the point at which any work done above it is anaerobic, and any work done underneath it, which is aerobic. So you increase it and you increase your cycling performance.
Yeah, FTHR is your heart rate at FTP. Now, to achieve that and to get it and to measure it, you're going to need some sort of power meter. Now, there's absolutely loads now on the market, but the ones we're using are Garmin Vectors with the Edge 1000 head unit on board. It's very, very important that you make sure they're accurate and calibrated, or at the very least, repeatable to themselves. Now, to measure your FTHR and your FTP, it's going to mean digging in and going pretty hard. So you need to be mentally fresh and ready for the job at hand. And when I mean that, you're going to need to feel, well, you're going to feel a little bit of pain in your legs. Or, now come to think of it, a lot of pain in your legs.
A mind-numbing amount of pain.
Definitely.
With FTP being, by its very definition, the average maximal power that you can sustain for 1 hour, it kind of makes sense then that the most accurate way to test it is to ride as hard as you can for 1 hour. Now, if you're going to do this, then you need to think very, very carefully about the route that you choose. So avoid traffic or junctions or descents, because any time that you have to stop pedaling, it'll dramatically skew your power and it'll skew it downwards. When it comes to pacing, that is absolutely critical. So the first 2 to 3 minutes of this is going to feel quite comfortable. It's really important to get clipped in as well before your threshold effort. Right, here we go. So the first couple of minutes are going to feel slightly easy. We're going to wait for the effort to come to us. At 10 to 15 minutes, your effort is really going to start to bite. And at this point, you can kind of gauge how hard you can try. And then at the end of your hour, you're going to be in the absolute box. Now, as I mentioned, an hour flat out is really physically, but also mentally demanding. You don't really want to repeat it too many times because it's so horrible. But fortunately, there are other slightly nicer ways of finding out your FTP.
Now, there is another way that's not too dissimilar to the last method to determine your FTP, but this one's about a third shorter. So rather than do it for an hour, you'll just ride hard for 20 minutes. Now, the first thing you need to do is have a good warm-up. So 15 to 20 minutes, nice and steady on the road. But within that, you need to do, for about 5 minutes, 2, 3, 4, 30 second very hard intervals, just to get used to what's coming up. Now, it's also very important to do this session on a stretch of road where you're not going to be interrupted and where you can keep a nice, smooth, even rhythm. So no road junctions, no descents. Ideally, a nice false flat, a little bit like this. And then you're ready to roll. Now, after your effort, get home and download your data onto something like Garmin Connect or Training Peaks. You then find your 20 minute peak and multiply that by 0.95 to find your pretty accurate functional threshold power. Now, most people can actually ride at 95% of their 20 minute power for an hour, give or take a few percentage points, depending on your physiology. But generally speaking, this is a great method to determine your FTP. I need a cuppa. Now, though establishing your FTHR is relatively straightforward, you need to bear in mind a few things, a few factors that could change things somewhat. There can be floats and your heart rate could be elevated, or sometimes even decreased if you're particularly fatigued. And also, if training in warm and hot conditions, your heart rate could be elevated too, by as much as 5 to 10 beats. Now, it also takes a while for your heart rate to increase. So although you're actually riding at FTP from the start of your effort, it could take for between 5 and 15 minutes for your heart rate to catch up with your power.
Yeah, so because of this, to calculate your threshold heart rate, we're recommending doing a 30-minute interval. So the first 10 minutes of this, you can pretty much assume that your heart rate isn't going to be at your functional threshold heart rate. So actually what you need to do is record your heart rate for the last 20 minutes of the effort, and that'll give you an accurate reading. But in terms of pacing, you simply go as hard as you can for 30 minutes, although obviously measuring your effort over the first part of it. The third and final method for calculating your FTP is also the easiest. It's not quite as easy as just sitting on a sofa, however, it does rely on you having done some really hard group rides or races that you've recorded on your power meter and that you've also got the data for. Simply download your data from your device onto a software package like Training Peaks or Golden Cheetah, and then you need to search for your maximum peak 60-minute normalized power. Normalized power is another concept to have come from Dr. Andy Coggan, and it's essentially an algorithm that takes into account the effort needed for any fluctuations in power during your ride or your race. So for example, a criterium race, you might have averaged 250 watts, but your normalized power is likely to be much higher, say for example 300 to 330 watts, and that's because your normalized power takes into account all those times when you've accelerated hard out of corners, or you accelerate to get into breakaways, or you're simply just dangling off the back of the bunch. Now, it has to be said as well that any method you choose for calculating your FTP, people find generally that their power is higher on the road compared to on their home trainer. So when it comes to choosing your method, then do take that into consideration. So now we've got our FTP or our FTHR, what are we going to do with them? Well, why not click up there to that video, which is how to train with a power meter, or you could click down there and you get through to a playlist which is all about GCN's training videos. Now, if you've liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and you like it, and subscribe to GCN, just click on me.